Martian by Pedro, Pablo, Sacristán. One night, a hedgehog was scanning the sky with his telescope when he saw what seemed to be a spaceship flying to the moon. When he managed to properly focus on it with his telescope, he found that it was a craft belonging to an unfortunate Martian who seemed to have an accident and have to make an emergency landing on the moon. The hedgehog realized that surely only himself had seen this, so he decided to try to save the Martian. He called together a few animals to help.
Hey, everyone, come over here and help me, help the Martian.
They couldn't think of what to do, so they called for more and more animals to join in. In the end, practically everyone in the forest was involved. It occurred to them that...
If we stand on top of each other, we can build a big tower and perhaps reach the moon together.
That proved somewhat difficult, and most animals ended up having a finger in one eye,
ouch,
someone's foot in their ear,
ow,
and numerous bumps on the head.
Oh.
However, after much perseverance, they finally reached the moon.
Help me.
And rescued the Martian.
Okay, now start climbing down, Martian friend.
Most unfortunately, while he was climbing down the Tower of Animals, the bear couldn't help sneezing.
Sorry, I happen to be allergic to moon dust.
The whole tower crashed to the earth with a great din comprising of howls, roars, and other assorted animal cries. Seeing all this, the Martian thought that the animals would get very angry with him because they would blame it all on him. But it was just the opposite. As they recovered from the fall, the animals jumped and clapped with joy, happy to have achieved something so difficult together.
Yay! Yahoo!
Yippee!
The whole day was spent partying. The Martian observed everything, and when he returned to his planet, the other Martians were astonished at what had happened. And so it was that those simple and helpful animals taught the Martians the importance of working together, joyful and in a team. Since then, Martians no longer traveled alone during their journeys through space. Now they go in groups, always willing to help each other and make sacrifices whenever necessary.
The Red Moon by Pedro Pablo Sacristán. There once was a little gray planet that was very sad. The people living there hadn't looked after it, despite them having all the intentions and spaceships you could ever need. They had contaminated the whole countryside, so much with rubbish and pollution, there were no plants or animals left. One day, a little boy was walking on the planet. He had passed a cave and noticed a small red flower inside. The last flower. It was very sick.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.